Life is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Good morning, Master.
Tell me, did you run to get here?
Yes, sir. I've been running 10 kilometers every day. 5 kilometers to get here, another 5 going home.
Very good. Keep doing that.
Master, what'll you teach me today?
Oh, all right. Do you see that corner? Go there and practice the planting legs position. Do it for 2 hours.
That's all? I want to learn actual combat techniques. I can do the planting legs position at home, Master.
Be quiet. Do it now, Xiaolong.
Yes, Master Ye.
Come now, breakfast is ready. Call your brother.
Brother!
No. Let's eat. Breakfast is getting cold.
I'll
set this up.
Breakfast is ready. Xiaolong, Hai Chuan.
I hear you.
Where's Xiaolong?
He went to the Kung Fu house early this morning.
He left without eating breakfast?
It's okay, dear. I told him to eat on the way. You know how our son is, right? If he sets his mind onto something, you can't stop him.
Wait a minute. Has Master Ye accepted our son?
I only introduced him to Master Ye. I'm not sure if he will accept him.
Good morning, Master.
Good morning.
Master, I've been doing planting legs position for over a week. May I practice with a brother today?
Xiaoyang, help him to strengthen his wrist.
Yes, Master. This way, Shaolong. Here you go. Can you lift this pole?
Of course I can. This is so light.
Don't hold it that way. Grab the pole from one end, then lift it evenly while planting your legs.
I'll do it. See, I can lift it evenly.
Can you maintain that position for an hour?
Brother, this doesn't make sense to me. Let's do something else. School is about to start. I don't want to spend my school break lifting poles.
Follow the basic rules, or you'll achieve nothing. If Master tells you to do something, you do it. Master, yeah, he's doing it.
Sit down, girl. Still studying?
Thanks, Ma.
Shaolong! What's wrong? Are you all right? Let me see your hand.
It's swollen.
Oh, what happened?
I plant my legs all day long while holding a long pole. They don't teach me anything.
Oh, dear.
Except look stupid.
It's only been a few days and you've had enough, huh?
Don't scold your son, Hai Chuan.
I know I must learn the basics, but not for a week. I can't become good by just doing nothing.
You insisted on studying martial arts. I was against it, but you never listened. Now all you do is complain about your training. Listen to me. Master Ye's reputation as a highly skilled kung fu master is well deserved. He's recognized not only here in Hong Kong, but also in Taiwan, Malaysia, and Singapore.
I know he's one of the best. But he doesn't teach me any useful stuff. It's all nonsense.
Here, Ma.
How can that be, huh? It's very useful. Son, when I was still at drama school, I had to do leg movement training and voice training. It didn't matter if the weather's good or bad, I just did it. Because those are basic skills.
That's enough, dear.
And now that I'm older, you still see me vocalize and do leg movement exercises. You want this kind of life? You have to stand by your decision.
Let's just eat.
Pa! Pa!
Sit down.
Pa! Tell Master Ye to teach me combat techniques. I don't want to waste my time. Summer vacation's almost over.
It's not that easy, son. But I'll do it if you promise me. You won't study martial arts anymore. Even if I have to lose face in front of Master Ye, I'll tell him what you want.
I want to learn Kung Fu. I just don't want to waste my time.
Then I can't help you.
Let's eat.
Begin! First position! Ha! 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 Ha!
Thank you.
Xiaoman, why are you here?
Why didn't you tell me you always come to this place? I went to see Alin. He said he hasn't seen you lately. So I asked your mother. She told me where I could find you.
So what?
We have a problem.
What is it?
Bruce, I told you last week. Our school asked us to join the Hong Kong High School Student Union Cha-Cha program.
But I also told you last week, I don't want a cha-cha anymore.
Hey, wait a minute! You'd rather stand all day holding a stick?
You saw me?
Yes.
Xiaoman, I was just fooling around.
I don't believe you.
It's true, I was just having fun.
Why don't you admit it? You don't want to see me anymore.
That's not true. Why would I not want to see you? Xiaoman, listen, it's not that I don't want to see you, but I've been anxious these past few days and also a little bit annoyed.
Annoyed with what?
I'm upset with Master Ye. Ever since he accepted me as his student, he doesn't teach me anything except to stand and hold a stick for hours. I don't know what's on his mind. It's really getting on my nerves.
Well, you ought to stop training then. Come with us instead and we'll perform in Singapore, Taiwan, and Malaysia.
No way.
Bruce, please. We're dance partners, right? If you won't come, I wouldn't have anyone to dance with.
I told you I don't want to dance anymore.
Bruce, please, you have to come with me.
No.
Do you mean that?
Yes, I do.
Really mean it?
Yes, really.
How long? That's enough. You'd better take a break.
No, Master.
You refuse to rest because I don't let you do anything except stand and hold a stick, am I right? Do you know why I ask you to keep planting your legs while holding a stick? Now it's clear to me, you still don't understand the essence of martial arts.
The essence?
When you're in that position, what goes through your mind?
I always ask myself, why do you make me do this kind of stuff?
And what else?
So I figured, I'll just do what you want. I'll stand here all day until you're satisfied. I won't disobey you.
Your words tell me that everything you've done these past few days were wasted.
Wasted? I don't understand.
Why do we do planting legs position?
Uncle Chow once told me the reason. We do it because it's a basic skill. Without basic skills, it's a waste of kung fu. So I do it. I know you'll teach me combat techniques soon. But if you want me to just plant my legs for the rest of my life, I'll do it too.
All right. Ruhai may have told you the importance of planting legs position, but sadly, you weren't able to perceive the principle behind it. It's true, planting legs is a basic skill to make our hip, waist, and leg muscles strong. But more importantly, it also makes our mind and spirit strong. The essence of Kung Fu is to strengthen our heart and soul. It teaches us to be calm and be at peace with ourselves. It's important. Being calm and at peace makes us stronger.
Planting legs can have that effect?
Yes, that's right. Xiaolong, you're too restless and impatient. It's very crucial for people practicing Kung Fu to make their mind, body, and spirit as calm as still water. A calm mind can span thousands of miles. With planting legs technique, think of yourself as a tree. Imagine that you're a big, tall tree reaching the sky. But no matter how tall the tree is, it still has its roots on the ground. And so should your mind and body take root into the earth. The deeper the root, the better your kung fu will be. You must strengthen your mind and body at the same time, until you can finally be one with heaven and earth.
One with heaven and earth?
When you have reached that level, your entire mind and body will be like water. From a big tree, you will turn into water which can penetrate everything here on Earth. Being in that state means you've reached a very high level of Kung Fu. Open your mind, let yourself go so you'll melt and be like water. Very calm water. Only when you can consciously make yourself melt like water can your mind and body melt into the Earth and be open to great wisdom. Only then will you find the way of Kung Fu. A very high state that only few individuals have achieved.
Hey.
Our master's here! Our master's here!
Master!
Welcome back, Master.
Thank you, Yunmi.
Continue practicing.
Did you ask him to hold the two sticks at the same time?
No, Master. He did it on his own.
Has he been doing that position ever since I was away?
Yes, Master. For several days now.
Good boy. He has the makings of a true martial artist. He's bored with just standing and holding one stick, so he found a creative way to ease his boredom. A remarkable kid.
Xiaolong, you silly boy, why didn't you eat your lunch? What are you doing over there?
Ma, you don't have to bring it up here. I'll eat later. I'm not hungry yet.
Xiaoman was here earlier. She still wants you to dance with her. She told me they're going to Taiwan, Singapore, and Malaysia for a dance performance. Imagine that. But she doesn't look happy.
I know, Ma.
What do you plan to do now?
Ma, I'll stop practicing.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I've been waiting for you to say those words, my dear. Haichuan! Haichuan! Xiaolong said he won't practice martial arts anymore.
What? No, Ma! You misunderstood me. What I mean is I don't want to cha-cha anymore. I only want to study martial arts.
Son, tell me, can't you think it over before you make a decision? You've won a cha-cha competition in Hong Kong because you've trained hard for it. Unlike martial arts, you've only been studying it for a few days. You haven't invested much time and effort in it. Can't you tell which one is important? What about Xiaoman? You're being unfair to her. Don't leave her alone, son. Listen to me. I don't want you to study martial arts, huh? If it's just a hobby, that's okay. But you're wasting your youth on such a trivial thing. What will your future be if you just concentrate on studying martial arts? How will you survive? Do you want your future wife and children to starve? Xiaolong, I'm begging you, son. Dance with Xiaoman again. You look good together. Who knows, maybe you'll both be famous one day.
Please stop saying those things, Ma. I said I won't go, so I won't. She can go to Taiwan, England, or America. I don't care.
How can you be so stubborn?
I'm sorry, Ma, but I'm just so angry. I don't understand. It's about Master Ye. He refuses to let me practice and train with other students. He hasn't taught me real kung fu, but he knows I'm better than most of the brothers. I have better fighting skills. He told me I should plant my legs and hold a stick. It's a basic skill. It'll make me more patient and calm. So if I go with Xiaoman to dance, all the pain I've been through will be wasted.
What pain are you talking about? You've just started training 2 weeks ago. What I don't understand is why you're being so stubborn.
I don't want to talk about this anymore. Just leave me alone.
So long.
Dear.
It's okay. Look at you. Don't turn your back on us.
I reached the lamp. I feel so light.
You're so light because you don't eat. You only think about kung fu.
Thank you.
Lower Shaolong. Good.
Master.
Good morning. Shaolong, starting today, you can pair up with one of your elder brothers to practice.
Really? That's great news, Master.
All right, go over there and practice with them.
Thank you, Master.
The skills of an O2 Spring shadow boxing fighter can be seen through actual combats. You'll also know then if you've made progress or not. Today, I want to see how much you've improved. I want you all to show me your kung fu skills. Pair up and start practicing actual combat. Move.
Shaolong, I can practice with you.
That's great, brother. I can learn a lot from you.
Yin Li, Shaolong is still a novice. Pair up with someone from your same level.
Master, it's okay. I want to learn from brother. I have to practice with a skilled fighter to improve.
You'll be hurt. You're not afraid of his fist?
Of course I am. But I know I have to receive some punches to develop my skills.
All right. Yin Li, let him attack first.
Let's do this!
Shaolong.
Very good, Yin Li.
Can I ask you something, brother? Is there a faster way that you know that can help me rapidly improve my fighting skills in actual hand combat?
There's an old kung fu rule. First, practice the basic skills. Second, refer to the first rule.
I know, brother. Why don't we practice together?
I can't. Master left me in charge with our other brothers. Besides, if you want to improve, you should fight with different opponents. When our master and brothers come back from Taiwan, you'll have more people to compete with.
But I can't wait another day. Let's go!
Silly kid.
You want another round, brother?
Xiaolong, you're very talented. Problem is, you can't focus. You're too anxious.
I need to speed things up. Summer's almost over and I have to go back to school again. So I'm trying to learn everything I can in a few days.
Martial arts requires lifelong commitment. It's not good to be too impatient.
What should I do then?
Do the basic skills again. Don't just practice with the woodman stand.
But Master Ye told me to practice with it.
Yes, Master told you that because he knows you're very talented. But still, you need to go back to basic skills. Before I got to practice with the woodman stand, I had to master the basic skills for 3 years. Our master always says, without talent, you can't be an ode to spring shadow boxing master. But talent without solid basic skills can never take you anywhere.
I understand, brother.
Practice some more.
All right.
Focus. Your posture, pace, balance, and stance must be accurate. This way. Your hands and feet can strike with speed, accuracy, and ferocity.
Yes, Master Yi.
Stop showing off. One more. That's it. Control the center line between you and your opponent. Watch the effective distance for attacking and defending. That's good. When you attack, defend right away. When you defend, attack. Good, Yin Li. Very good.
Brother.
Good, Xiaolong.
Got him!
Another round.
Yin Li, that's enough for today. Xiaolong. You just used flowery fists and stealthy feet. Did your Uncle Chao teach you those styles?
No, Master. I read it in a book and figured it out myself.
Is that so? Tell me, how did you do it, Xiaolong?
It happened last year. A schoolmate beat me up, and he practices Western boxing. I didn't want him to think he defeated me, so I read some martial arts books. Then I read something like this. A pig pushes with its snout. A rooster fights with its wings. Different ways of fighting. Learn from the pig if you want to defend yourself. Lift your butt and move forward. But you should be like a rooster if you want to attack. A rooster, when it's attacking, doesn't use its beak. When it attacks, we can see its wings keep on moving. Then they peck at the same time, but actually, that's just to distract the opponent so it doesn't notice the rooster charging him. What the rooster's doing with its wings are just a diversion. Its real weapons are the spurs of its feet, which is concealed by the distraction.
You figured it out from books written by crazy martial arts authors. You're really a smart kid. Very good. I'm very impressed. When practicing Kung Fu, you should also sharpen your mind. Only a sharp mind can perceive the way of Kung Fu from everything on this earth. Xiaolong, continue to read books. I'm proud of you.
I understand, Master. The key to mastering Kung Fu is to sharpen your mind.
You're very talented and smart. Remember to get rid of the fancy moves when you're training for combat. Give up the non-essentials. Focus on strategy.
Yes, Master. No fancy moves. Strategize. But, Master, how do you do it?
If you give up the non-essentials, you'll be able to think of a fast way to defeat your opponents.
Give up the non-essentials. Focus on strategy.
Got it.
Yes, Master.
Thank you.
That's great. You're making progress with your kicks.
Wow.
You too. Your punches are stronger.
Okay. Let's practice together.
All right.
Get up. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. One. Two. Three. Four.
Down, don't drag me.
Hurry up.
Bruce, why'd you take me here?
Stop complaining. Get in there. Get that yellow brat here. Use your head. Don't worry, he won't hurt you.
Hurry up. Right already.
Get in there.
Oh,
go.
Wait a minute. What do I tell him?
Tell the yellow brat. His worst nightmare is here.
What did you say? My worst nightmare?
Good, you heard that.
You're a smart aleck.
I'd like to learn something from you.
It seems I didn't kick you hard enough the last time. Tell me, what do you want me to break? Your ribs or your legs?
Hey, wait a minute, wait. What if I break your ribs or your legs, huh? What then?
Yeah. Then I'll say you're great. Come on.
No, Bruce. You want to die here?
Move, Alin. Use your legs. Come on, use it. Master Wang, I just wanted to learn something from your apprentice.
No! Stop! Enough! It's you again. Why do you always bother us?
If you didn't stop us, I would have beaten him up by now.
You're Li Xiaolong, right? Son of Mr. Hai Chuan Li?
That's right.
Why are you here again?
I have to be here. Because I want to...
To get even? Because he defeated you first?
That's true. But we're outside your house. We didn't break any rules.
You're a really conceited brat who needs to be punished. When your master comes back from Taiwan, I'll arrange a fight. The kick of Wang Jia versus Ode to Spring Fist. But right now, I don't have time for you. Don't you know what the date is today? Go and get ready.
Thank you.
I can't take this.
That's just a small amount. Nowadays, if you want to have at least a decent life, you need to have money, Master Wang. Huh? Without money, how are you going to run your kung fu house? Your noble aim is to support your students. Huh? But you have lots of students, Master Wang. How can you provide for all of them? Huh? So here, take it. I'm giving it as a present.
All right. I'll take it.
You deserve it, Master Wang.
Come here. You'll be under Mr. Wang Li Chao's wings now. You'll be his hand and foot. Both hands and feet can be broken, but not Mr. Li Chao. You must never put his life in danger, you understand?
Yes, Master.
Such a gorgeous kid. What's your name?
Oh, I'm sorry, but he has no name. Ever since he came here, he has always been pale and skinny. He doesn't have a name, so I just call him Yellow Brat.
What? Yellow Brat?
Oh, if you feel awkward, don't call him Yellow Brat. You may give him a new name instead.
No. It's good. He'll be known as Yellow Brat. Tough name. Bring it here.
Brother, you didn't have to.
It's okay. I'll tell you what. All those poor guys you see in the street have handed in quite a lot of money. So I came here to bring rice, flour, oil for you and your students. I brought some clothes too. At least your apprentices have something decent to wear outside, right?
Li Chao, in behalf of them, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Song Liang, begin.
Yes, Master. Yin Li, you'll defend.
Yes, brother.
Xiao Long.
Master.
Master.
All right, go and get ready. Try to connect to make a point, understand? Okay, ready? Fight! Xiao Long, when you use Ode to Spring style, don't stick to its patterns of skills and tricks. Do whatever you feel like doing. Be on guard, Yin Li.
Brother, are you okay?
I'm okay. Shalom, you used the inch fist.
I didn't do it on purpose.
It's amazing. You just started training, but you did it. I'm proud of you, Shalom.
He's right. We're proud of you. Are you okay, Yin Li?
Yeah.
Shalom. It's true, you were able to use the inch fist skill, but you didn't do it very well. Your brother, Yin Li, didn't expect you to do it, so he was caught off guard. And you defeated him. But we can't dismiss the fact that you did it in such a short time. You're very lucky. Your brother Yin Li's defensive mistake was your gain.
Yes, Master. I didn't expect it either.
I noticed that your punches have power in it.
Xiao Long, in order to learn a certain style of fighting, you need to know the principle behind it and get the essence of it. Song Liang taught you how to do it. Now that you have the basic skill, you must put your whole heart into it. That part will take some time to master. Practice board. Give it a try. Punch harder. You've learned the principle behind the one-inch fist. It needs tremendous strength. But then, to smash the board with an inch fist will require long hours of training. You can't do it in a single day. Xiao Long, remember this. What you're learning now is true kung fu. Maybe someday there will come a time
The movements, principles, essential styles of fighting will be of less importance. Because with continuous practice, anyone who wants to can learn it. But to be a real martial artist, get power from your feet and punch out from your heart. Attack whenever you can and defend each inch of land.
Get power from the feet and punch out from the heart? Attack whenever you can and defend each inch of land.
It's like a kid holding and playing a concave mirror to set a piece of paper on fire. The concave mirror collects the sunlight and converges it to a certain point in the mirror. It can set anything ablaze.
I understand, Master.
You must also utilize the power of your opponent.
Master, you mean the attacking power coming from your opponent can be utilized by way of getting it back on him in a split second? So you can use his energy?
Just spend time meditating on what we've discussed and try to learn it in your heart. A highly skilled kung fu artist knows when to attack. He concentrates all his energy at a certain point, then releases that energy in a single flash. While defending, you must be able to break your opponent's offense in a twinkling. You must shift between offense and defense with the suddenness of a thunderbolt, then launch an attack to your opponent with the same speed. Now with a combination of offense and defense, you'll continuously hit and weaken the power of your opponent. This is the level of power you should be able to achieve when using Otis Spring shadow boxing style. In other words, you must always be prepared to defend while you attack, and attack while you defend. This would require tremendous speed and great amount of skill. This is the way you should practice your kung fu.
Quiet.